A big hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there to my channel, The Twin Flame Union. And in this channeling session, I would be talking about the emotions within the divine feminine and masculine both, and which is also an emotion of the ascension journey right now on the whole. And that is feeling the highs and the lows of this journey. And both of them are feeling the highs and the lows of the journey in such a way, in a very deep and mature way, that they understand that we need to rise above this, because this is going to keep happening. You know, if this is going to keep happening, then we will never be at peace and we will never be at ease. So let's get started and let's understand the energy of this channeling so that it can help as many people as possible. So one of the biggest area of work in the twin flame journey is to heal the wounded templates. So for the feminine, it is the template, it is the pain of abandonment, neglect, and being ignored, completely ignored, neglected, not treated with love as a child. And the on the opposite side with the masculine, it is the fear, the constant fear of rejection, which is always hanging in his energy. And after a lot of, you know, separation, and after making a lot of wrong decisions, or you can say decisions that were a result of other people's decision making, he understands that he might have been a borderline narcissistic, and the feminine understands that she's been an oversensitive empath. So what they need to clear out is the empathy is great and self-love is great, but we need to remove the excess of it, which is being extra sensitive, and the mirroring is done by borderline narcissism. Obviously, they are not bad human beings. They are good human beings. And they, again, I would not go into the good and bad aspect of it. I would like to rather go into the authentic side of it. So both of them are authentic human beings. And what has happened with them is that they have not been brought up in a way that they could be completely independent and not get affected by their fears, be it fears of abandonment or be it fears of rejection. Or if not rejection, then you can substitute that fear with, this is never going to work out or this is never going to happen. For the divine feminine, it's the feeling of loneliness, and for the masculine, it is the karmic stuff that he needs to heal. And she's scared of being lonely. She's scared of, you know, having no one around her. And that particular fear is so deep and so strangling. It is so choking for her sometimes. Or, you know, it's like you wake up in the morning sometimes and the first thing you feel is something very empty. Something that makes you feel that you have nobody around you, nobody to, you know, love you, nobody to understand you. And it's almost like when she's going through this, she does have, you know, in her life, she does have biological family members, or, you know, sisters or brothers or aunties or uncles or whatever, you know, all those people. But yet she has been, you know, they would want to see her in pain. And I don't want to say this in a way that it sounds like, you know, there is a blame being put on other people. And that is the blame that she needs to release. Because first, for many of the divine feminines, they don't even know where this feeling of hollowness is coming from. For many years, they don't know why they feel hollow, why they feel empty. What are they trying to, you know, why are they so scared of being alone? It's because this is how they've been treated in childhood, when, you know, they were not acknowledged, they were not loved, and they were completely neglected. You know, completely neglected. It's like the baby is in the pram and the baby is hungry, the baby is crying. The baby is screaming and crying out of hunger, it's howling. And after so much of howling, it goes to sleep after being tired. But the mother, who's probably chit-chatting, you know, with somebody who's maybe in the distance, she knows that I have not fed my child for 5 hours, 6 hours. The child must be awake. The child could be crying or howling. But she's so busy gossiping with other people, or she's just so busy, you know, maintaining her societal bond or something. trying to talk about something which is so meaningless from the child's perspective or from a mother child perspective, that she's willing to take that risk or she's willing to do that. And this is the reason why a lot of women who have been treated badly by the narcissistic mothers, they sometimes become overbearing on their own children. And even if they love their children a lot, even if they do everything for the child, they always feel that I have not done enough. And they have a fear of losing, their own child. Or if they don't have children, then, somebody that substitutes that feeling of nurturing. And if not that, then, they are constantly in fear of feeling that I'm not good enough. So the divine masculine, when she meets the divine masculine, when the, before the separation also, before things go really wrong, she feels this feeling that I'm not good enough, or he's not going to love me, he will ignore me. So even before, he ignores her, or even before something happened, she gets into that fear that he is definitely going to ignore me. But there is no word to it, there's no label to it, there's no, how do I say it, what do I feel? It's only when you do inner work, it's only when you do deep inner work, like you've come across this channel where, I try to bring up these issues as much as I can, because every time an energy update comes, every week or every 15 days or every, whenever the energy updates are there or it changes, it is the theme of the channelings that, or that particular channeling, that this is the energy like. This is the work that needs to be done, and this is how you are going to feel better and more relaxed. A lot of people resonate with the challenges because the earth is ascending in the same way as you are ascending, and that's why they say you are the creator of your own heaven on earth. That's why they say that. So individually, when more and more people can create their heaven on earth, that's when, maximum energy, more energy is going to be, majority of the energy is going to be like that, which pushes the earth up. So this comes when, first of all, you become very nonchalant, and secondly, you have to cut your ties from toxic people and toxic situations. Even if that includes the divine masculine, even if that includes, for the time being, if you feel that there is, a lot of toxicity in your life and there's a lot of blame game, there are too many fights and all of this. And if, for example, you have already crossed that stage and he has blocked you, he doesn't want to talk to you, and even worse, that he's chosen someone else and he's in a karmic relationship or whatever, then energetically and mentally also you have to sever those ties. You have to just become a person who doesn't have to be answerable to people. If you're convincing people, if you're answering people, if you're trying to put your point across, it means that those people definitely should not be around you. That is where you should draw a line, that, if I have to explain so much, if I have to convince them so much, if I have to always act as the pacifier, then there's no need to act as a pacifier. And I'll also tell you one more thing, that all these relationships also eventually heal. In some cases, the parents have crossed over, they are no more, but still their energy is always around. So what do you do at that point in time? You have to heal that energy, because the impact of that particular energy will hover around in your life in the form of other relationships. So without feeling, that they have done this to me, and how could they do it to me? You have to just let them go. You have to release them, and you have to maintain yourself. You have to maintain maximum no contact, or maximum you have to be like, I'm not going to interact with them. Maybe you tried putting your point across, you tried reaching out to them, if you are in that position. And if you are in the position where you feel that the toxic people, despite doing all the toxicity, all the bad things, all the crazy things, they still keep coming back to you and they still keep saying, I'm sorry, I did that to you, please forgive me, I'll not do it again. But you know that they will do this again in the future. So why to feel bad about it? Why to feel bad about them? Because they've already ruined a certain type or certain part of your life, And if you're going to blame them, then you will keep burning in that fire. Now, what happens with the divine masculine, the energy shift that they both are going to feel now is the energy of high and lows. So why do we need to work on this, and why do we need to come on the center? It's because, first of all, that excitement and that feeling of ecstasy has to go when you are connecting with your divine masculine and divine feminine. and you need to see things as how they are. This is one of the teachings in Vipassana meditation also, and this is also the teaching of all great masters like my own guru, and they keep teaching us to be in the neutral position, neutral place of emotions, and whatever, you know, whenever you feel very low, you have to understand that it is a result of feeling very high, and whenever you're feeling very high, then you know there will be a certain low. You're supposed to be in the zone where you are high without you know, any sort of a chemical intake or any sort of a feeling where you have to try too hard to be happy. If you're trying to be happy, you will be happy after some time, you know, you'll be working on how to be happy. But when you know, you reach that place where you don't even have to try, you know, the happiness quotient is basically, I am not separate. I am complete, whole and divine. I am complete, whole and divine, no matter where I am and no matter what I'm doing. And whatever happens to me, I have the source, and eventually everything will be all right. Like, you know, it may look like today you're in separation, or today you're being misunderstood, and you've tried everything to, you know, find out the truth or make other people understand, but it's not working out, especially in case of your DM. You tried everything, you messaged, you called, you convinced, you met, and you begged them to understand you. It did not work out. So you have to leave it over there, and you have to forgive them, and you have to forgive your own self, and then, you know, forget about it. When you feel the lows, when you feel like that empty feeling, that hollow feeling, and this is especially for Divine Feminine right now, because once she heals this feeling, the Divine Masculine will automatically get healed from his fear of rejection. He will start reaching out to you. He will start connecting with you. He will be more open to what you have to say, because previously he was not open to what you have to say. Previously he was not even open with the fact that, you know, this can really work out. Is this really possible? Am I going to pull this relationship off despite all the differences we have? Now, not all people are twin flames. I must say this, because personally also it may look like, you know, you look at somebody who is struggling a lot, or who says that I've gone through a lot. But they have so much support around them. They have so much parental support around them, be it the mother or be it the father, be it the siblings. Even if they look like, you know, they have had some difficulties, or they are struggling, or they are doing this or doing that. Twin flames are different from other people. Twin flames are definitely different from other people. And they have to create their own vibe around them if they want to be, you know, in the state of being nonchalant, the real bliss. You know, we tell people, yeah, like I said, you know, highs and lows, but there is a real high and there is a real bliss, which in Hindi is called Sad Chit Anand. So how does the Divine Feminine and the Divine Masculine, first of all, they come to this conclusion that the person I am running away from, or the person I'm chasing, in both the cases, if this person is mine, if I love this person, of course you love that person and they love you, the feeling that you have felt for that person is genuine, it's real. You both know that for sure, okay? If you both know that for sure, then what's going to happen is that you will have to let go of the feeling of being separate from each other. Even if in the worldly world, it looks completely impossible. Thanks to the separation, because of the separation, which a lot of people see as separation, but later on when they get out of the separation phase, they do realize that this has been one of the greatest things that happened to them, or else they won't be where they are today, very nonchalant, and, you know, someone who doesn't give a rat's ass to whatever happens around them, and they're just, you know, living their life, doing their mission work, because they understand that, you know, I was also down in the dumps once, and I had nobody to love me, nobody to hold me, nobody to hug me, nobody to say that, look, child, I am there for you. So what happens is, in the case of the feminine as well as the masculine, they somehow lose out on their childhood. They are supposed to, you know, either be an adult or act as an adult, or they are you know, treated like a child for too long and too much, you know. This is the type of polarity both of them face. Masculines normally, you know, they are too pampered, too taken care of. You know, somebody is always around them. So they cannot make their own decisions. They feel very bad about it. They want to make their own decisions. They want to be independent, but they're not able to do that. And the feminines, on the other hand, they are told to, you know, and this feminine energy can be in the man and the woman, anyone. In the twin flame world also, you know, when you see a lot of masters and healers and coaches, a lot of them, men, normally have the feminine energy. That's why they were the chasers. Why? Because as a child, they were told to be, you know, told to act like the husband of the mother or like the father of the mother. It was like they were always the referee in the relationship between the mother and the father. So they were always taking care as a surrogate husband or as a surrogate father, you know, father of these grown-ups. They were basically always made to think, or they started thinking also, and very proudly they would think about this, that they are my children. Instead of saying that I am their child, they would think that they are my children. And that's why a lot of, you know, upcoming twin flamers, the new age twin flamers, they don't want to have children. Because as a child, they have literally raised their mothers or their fathers. They have taken care of them so much that they understand that, you know, I am a nurturer and I am a parent already. They have gone through the stages of the parents. Parents don't realize that, you know. They don't realize that because they feel that, you know, I am also suffering so much. I have gone through so much. You know, it is my this, it is my that, my pain, my trauma, my suffering. So they have also gone through pain. Obviously, people who are in pain, they only act this way, you know. They're all broken, they're all wounded, they're all hurt. But what happens on the child, be it sons or the daughters, they are always taking care of them, the elders. So they lose their part in them, which is the actual child, the real child, you know. Or the age of becoming a child or living as a child, there is a disparity, there is a problem in that, you know. Either the one is becoming an elderly person too soon, acting as an adult too soon, or the other one is acting like a child, or, you know, or being compared or always being told that, no, you don't know much, you're a child, you're too young, you're very young, you know, you can't do this, you can't do that. So in case of divine feminine and masculine also, one of the biggest triggers that the masculine feels, especially because he is younger to the, you know, in cases where he is younger to the feminine, he feels, you know, I'm younger to her. So there is a trigger in that, because they've always been told, or they've always been, you know, this thing has been slapped on their face that you don't know what to do. You're too immature. You're too young. You're too young for this. You're too young for that. So they feel very bad when the feminine also makes them feel that way, because she's like the, you know, the elder one or the more mature one. And from the feminine's perspective, he tries to give her this label that you are immature. You are immature. You don't know much. I know better. And the feminine also gives it back to him that, you know, you should act like this, or you should do this, or you should do that. So there is a tug of war between both of them. And then there is this high, there are these highs and lows that they go through. And I'm talking about the highs and lows, not the permanent high, but the highs and lows that are very energetically very difficult. Like, you know, you are very happy throughout the day. You are really smiling, and you know that this is, I'm in such a good space right now. But something happens that really disturbs the peace of your mind. And you end up taking some action, or you end up doing something about it. And then you regret even more that, why did I even do this? Why did I even send this message? Or why did I even make this call? Or why did I even argue with these people? Because it's pointless to do this. It's pointless to do this. It's better to heal. Once you heal, you obviously heal that feeling also, that why did I take that action? Because you understand that this was your coping mechanism, you know. So you then get into the zone of forgiveness. You forgive yourself and you forgive those people who have hurt you. And when you have grown up, you know, like a person who doesn't know exactly whether you're a child or you're an adult, you sit and think like, what happened to my childhood? Like, where did my childhood go? You know, and If you look at all the people who have a very practical, very straight, very simple life, or very, you know, they have everything they want and they are just so relaxed, you feel, how come they are so confident? The masculine shows this trait to the feminine as well. When he runs away or when he takes all those decisions, all the wrong decisions, he's so confident, you know. There's this level of confidence that he shows to her. And she feels that, you know, she feels like she's stuck in this loop, in a limbo. You know, whether she should act like this or whether she should act like that. And then we also say in our journey that you need to protect your inner child. You should live like a happy child, you know, you should live like a nonchalant child. But the actual way of living is that you are the same child and you are the same adult. Your inner child has to be looked after, your healed adult, you know, the healed adult when you become the healed adult. So instead of blaming the narcissistic parents, or instead of healing the absent parents, or instead of healing the helpless parent, because there is this dynamic where the parents are so helpless or they act so helpless in front of the child that the child doesn't know what to do. The child has less of confidence. The child has not grown better. You know, they don't know what to do, and they suffer in their relationships too. Their relationships are very incomplete because they are so helpless. They have always seen helplessness around them. They don't see that confidence level that, you know, I'm there with you. I'm going to support you. Do whatever you want to do. You know, as a parent, I'm there for you. They have not seen that. So when they have not seen that, it really hurts them, or they feel that hollowness and that emptiness. So the best way to do is, when you're healing your feelings, you need to, first of all, you need to find your own techniques. You need to find your ways, whether you do it therapeutically, whether you do it via listening to channelings like these, whether you, go to somebody, whether you have a doctor, and I don't mean the doctors that give you pills and chemicals. I mean, you know, if you have some kind of a healer, or you have found your own ways, or you go to the master, you talk to universe, you make prayers, or you meditate, or you dance, or you sing, or you take care of animals, or whatever is your way, you paint, whatever way you have found out, you know, you first need to heal yourself. And then you need to disconnect with all of those toxic elements. You know, you need to totally disconnect. Once you totally disconnect, then you can rise above them, because you don't need that. You don't need them. You know, you need to understand that I don't need them. They might need me, because once you heal, they will come to you. They will come to you for that energy. But even then, you can't think like, oh, they've come to me for the energy. You just have to be very nonchalant, and you have to be like, I don't need this. I just need to be neutral, and anything that tries to persuade me down, take me down, bring me down, or anything, you know, you have to also be very conscious of what is making you too happy, too jumpy, too ecstatic. Even that is not good for us, for twin flamers, for the twin flame community. And as I said, that everyone is not in a twin flame journey, you know, you would know you are, you know, it's very easy to know. So that part of you that was abused, that was injured, that was neglected, that was killed, you feel it got killed. You know, you can't live in the past. You have to get up. You have to love your solitude. You have to love your hermitage. You have to own it, and you have to see how amazing it is to be in that zone, you know. And if you're feeling depressed right now, you know, while I'm into this channeling, some of you might be sad, some of you might be still working, some of you could be in whatever zone, but I know if you're resonating with this, then you are feeling this way because you know that you're not able to give love to that inner child. You're not able to tell that inner child that, you know, I am there for you. I will hold you up. I am there for the adult that you are, you know. So, I would like to say that this high and low is happening in the masculine as well, and it's happening in the feminine as well. You know, when this happens in them, like, a lot of masculines have this feeling of, you know, they feel everything in the world is pointless, everything is useless, everything is stupid. They would keep saying, what's the point of this? What's the point of this? It's so temporary. You're not going to get anything out of it. Of course, everything is temporary, but they see it in a very negative way. Everything is pointless any which way, but they see it in a negative way. You know, and when they get out of this trap, when they get out of this, you know, loop that they get stuck in, that is the time they will understand the feminine much more, and they will understand the mission that she is into much more, because it is the feminine who runs the mission actually on her shoulder. And the mature person, you know, he is also the mature person, but he becomes more mature by understanding that not everyone is going to do like a separate mission. There are some people who need support, so he will give her that support, he will give her that love, he will give her that acknowledgement, you know, and he will be like, I'm proud of you. Whatever you're doing is great. I'm so proud of you. That way. And if you have not reached that stage yet, it means that, you know, you can, first you need to develop it on your own. When you develop that attitude of gratitude, when you develop loving your company no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, no matter if you're with 100 people or if you're with 10 people or you're just alone. Because this is the thing, you know, when you spend a lot of time alone, you become so amazing. Your frequency is very high. You're vibing very high. You attract some people. But when those people go away, then you are back feeling alone and you're, you know, thinking that, what should I do next? And, you know, what's going to happen next? So this is the time you need to tell yourself that, hey, I was that way only. That's why I attracted. So people can come and go. And this is the same thing that happens in the runner-chaser dynamic. But by the time you mature, by the time you grow, you understand that this runner-chaser dynamic is an illusion. Because your relationship, a twin flame relationship, is not going to be same as a regular relationship. You cannot live like regular people. You're not going to have that regular lifestyle. You will not. Trust me, you will not, and you don't need to. And you will realize that, yes, not being regular, not being machine-like, not being the same, that is my gift. So you will not be disturbed or you not be difficult when the masculine comes and goes. Which they will come and go for a certain period of time. After that, you'll become totally reactionless. After that, you'll be just on your own. That is what this whole journey is going to do. And, you know, as I said, Vipassana meditation or any other greatest masters have said this, to see things as how they are, to see things as how they are, to see things as how they are. And when you see things as how they are, one of the biggest things that you will see is that you are complete, whole and divine, no matter what, no matter where you are. On that note, I'm going to end this channeling here. Thank you so much for being here with me. I love you a lot. One love and peace out.